Hi everybody, this is Kevin the Postcard Guy here from Sarasota, Florida. Just checking in. This is part three of my latest postcard haul, and just wanted to go through these latest cards that just arrived and share them with everybody before they get listed on eBay or on whatnot or wherever I sell them. Sell them at local shows as well. So again, these are cards that came from a collection up in upstate New York that I've been purchasing over time. And this is the latest grouping of cards that just came in. So let's share these real quickly. I'll go through them quickly. This is a real photo of some type of early barge or bridge. Not sure where that is, but it's postmarked New York, 1908. I'll have to do some more research on that. I love these real photos. A lot of history in them. Here's a real photo of Norwich, New York. After the Fleet storm in 1902, it looks like, or 1909 probably. So just a storm picture in the snow. Very neat card. Wow, a bunch of real photos in this group. Mr. and Mrs. Finley J. Shepherd, Roxbury in the Catskills. So this is their home up in the Catskills Mountains. Not postmarked on the back. You got a small town view here of Williamson, New York. Got the State Bank on the left-hand side there. You got a lot of storefronts in view. Looks like maybe trolley tracks down the middle of the street. You got some signage and some products out on the sidewalk for sale. Gotta love these real photos. A lot of detail in them. Over here you have East Main Street in Richmondville, New York. Another good card with storefronts and businesses. Postmarked 1908. Plenty of real photos in this group. This is Bombay, New York. Not much there. It looks almost like a Western town, but it's really upstate New York. It's got that Western town look. Not much in view. Nobody walking around. I don't see anything going on. Looks like a sleepy day there. It is postmarked 1914 on the back. You got a boat landing bridge at Jack's Reefs. And you got all these canoes or boats there on the water. You got a wooden covered bridge, which is really, really cool. People do collect cover bridges, so they're very popular. And this is around the area of Jordan, New York. Next, we have a view of Webb Block in Mexico, New York. Love some of these small town names. I have no idea where they come up with them, but this one is called Mexico, New York. You got a horse and wagon out front. You got lots of buildings in view. Looks like a great little town. Postmarked on the back. Or not actually, not postmarked on the back. Going on to a Needsport, New York. Small town, real photo view. You got a tobacco store there on the right. You got some horses and wagons in view, some signage. Looks like an old hotel on the left. And these were the prices that he paid originally. This gentleman's been collecting for over 40 years and collected the best of the best, especially in the area of real photos and holidays, better holiday cards, hold to lights, Halloweens, things like that. This is interesting. This is a wine company in New York, Brockton, New York. This is the Reichmann Wine Company. So that must be their factory, incorporated in 1905. Nice occupational view there, or business view. And it's got information on the back. Wow, look at this view here. This is the Champagne Vaults at the Pleasant Valley Wine Company in New York, Hammondsport, New York. Look at all the bottles of champagne. Again, this is great for advertising collectors, liquor collectors, wine, that type of thing. That's a wine vault, probably underground. Not postmarked on the back. You got Brooklyn Avenue in Breakabene, New York. Very early view. Love it when you have views with both horses and wagons and early automobiles. This is that time period where they were just crossing over from horse-drawn vehicles to automobiles or motorized vehicles. And again, for a period of several years, you had both horses and wagons and cars sharing the road at the same time. So very interesting time period in history. Postmarked on the back. Got a very rustic looking bridge there somewhere. Real photo over the water. Amsterdam, New York. Nice early view. This is a view of a camp, Camp Pocahontas at Willsboro, New York. Bunch of kids there with a salute to the flag. Very cool card. You got Main Street, Tupper Lake, New York. Real photo view. And again, real photos, you can tell if you take a loop to these images, you will not see a series of dots at all. They were not printed on a traditional printer or a printing press. These were made in a dark room from a negative made from a camera. So real photos are actually what the photographer saw on that day, on that time. And they are real photographs, hence the name Real Photograph Postcard, or RPPC, or as we call them, RPs, real photos. So if you see those abbreviations, RPs or RPPCs, those are real photo postcards made from the negative, developed in a darkroom, and printed on postcard stock right in the darkroom. So again, these are limited runs normally. They'll be from just a handful made to maybe a couple hundred. These are not normally mass-produced like the lithograph cards are. These are just made for the locals to show, you know, where they live and what their town looks like. And maybe if somebody visited, they picked up a few. So real photos could be a little bit more rare sometimes. Not always, but a little bit more rare than a traditional lithograph postcard or a chrome postcard. This is Morrisville, Eaton Street. Nice early real photo. And again, these are card prices that he paid back in the day over the last 40 years. Here's Mosier's store, North Lawrence, New York. Nice early department store or grocery store. Here's a boat launch in Cranberry Lake, New York. Nice early wooden boat flying the flags at the front and the back. Cranberry Lake, New York, St. Lawrence County. Division Street, Forest Park, New York. Another real photo. And we have the Blaisdell Sperry Manufacturing Company, Martville, New York. Wow, look at the state of that building. This one is super early over there. This one looks like it's ready to fall down, and they are a manufacturing company. Very, very cool. Postmarked on the back. Here's a nice early motorcycle with sidecar. You got a bunch of people there in view. About to do some research on this card and get the manufacturer of the motorcycle. It is not postmarked on the back. Over to Mechanicsburg, Pennsylvania. This is the Williams Grove Speedway. Very early racetrack. This is a real photo aerial of that speedway in Pennsylvania. Again, anything auto racing I do very, very well with. Here's another one. Williams Grove Speedway, Mechanicsburg, Pennsylvania. You got a couple early cars racing there. You got the wooden guardrails. You got the spectators in the middle. Very, very cool card. You got an old bridge, steel bridge at St. Johnsville, probably New York, I guess. Nope, Montana. I think it says Montana. Falls and mill at East Nassau. Nice mill view there with the waterfalls. Postmarked on the back. Very, very neat card. Love the early automobiles and delivery trucks in this one. Main Street at Delhi, New York. Nice early buildings. Some signage, some early automobiles and trucks. Postmark 19, looks like 34 on that one. Coming up on the last part of this group, here's an old, I guess a church or a school? I guess a school. St. Bona Company, Allegheny, New York. To do some research there. Nicholsville, New York. That's a new bridge being built. And postmarked on the back. This was a very popular company up in the New York State area. This was the Eastern Illustrating Company out of Belfast, Maine. As far as real photos go, they are one of the largest publishers of real photo postcards. I wouldn't say they're common, but you will see a lot more of this publisher in the upstate New York area than the others. They have a great vignette on the back. You'll see this on the back of many, many upstate New York cards, Maine cards, Massachusetts cards, that area. But they were one of the big publishers of real photos back then. This is New York State Hospital at Raybrook, New York. Not sure what kind of hospital that is, but I'll have to do some research. I know Mark from SMS Postcards did a segment this week on hospital postcards. So it'll be interesting for me to do some research, see what kind of hospital this is. If it's a general hospital, if it's a mental hospital, it could be some kind of rest home, could be almost anything, but we'll do some research on that. Here's one of a motorcycle. Nice early motorcycle there. And I can't see the tank through the camera here, but I'm sure you guys probably can see the name. Do some research on that. We got some more here. Let me flip these around. Nice early motorcycle and sidecar. Love the lady sitting in the basket on the side. It is not postmarked. Here's a linen advertising postcard for the 41 Indian 45 model with double action spring frame. These litho or linen cards are great advertising, especially for motorcycles. It is postmarked on the back, 1941. Again, one of my categories I specialize in is motorcycles, automotive racing, cars, trucks, advertising, that kind of stuff. Here's come in and see the new 1940 Indian now on display. Again, a linen postcard from the 40s. And somebody sent it for your collection. Okay, wow, a lot of motorcycles in this group. Nice early motorcycle there, Oscar Sandberg and Albert Johnson, uncle, riding on a nice early bike there, early motorbike. And it confirms I'm on the back again. Not sure the make and model. You guys can probably see it better than me. But nice early motorcycle. Wow, this is a huge group of motorcycles. Another linen postcard here. Got the man with the Indian motorcycle sweater on. Indian, world's best modern motorcycle. Nice advertising postcard there for the Indian. Wow, more motorcycles. This is Binghamton, New York, coast to coast on a motorcycle with a sidecar. Very cool image there. That is a litho postcard, so it is printed, but still could be a very rare card if there wasn't that many made. It is not postmarked. It has an undivided back. Again, undivided back means this side here is only for the address. Does not have a split back. Another nice early motorcycle here. Professional champion of the United States with the Eclipse coaster brake and free engine pulley on his motorcycle at Hotel Plaza, New York. So you got him superimposed there as a giant, like on a motorcycle in front of a landmark in New York. Very cool early advertising card. And there you go on the back. It's dated 1911. And it talks about him being a racer and this is special Eclipse free engine pulley and the Eclipse machine company is hand typed from the company. So that could be a very good card there. Here's another similar card with another gentleman, another racer bike. And this time he's in front of a church in New York. Again, advertising card for this motorcycle equipment. Couple more motorcycles, it looks like. Come in and see the new Harley-Davidson. This is a litho postcard. Nice early card. Over here, Factory Service School, Indian Motorcycle Company, Springfield, Mass. Now, this is one I've never seen before in all my years of collecting. This came direct from the Indian Motorcycle Company, and it's from their Factory Service School for mechanics. And on the back, this is an application if you'd like to apply to become a student. Dated 1925. It's never been postally sent. Do you have any previous experience as a repairman? Love that. Ask if you're a dealer, a repairman, or a salesman, your age, whether you're married or single. Wow, you can never ask those things these days. Very cool card. I'm hoping that'll be a really good one for Indian motorcycle collectors. Again, never seen that card before. Over here, you have a Sunbeam motorcycle advertising postcard. What a great Real photo, that is direct from the dealer. It's an advertising postcard for the Sunbeam motorcycle. Not real familiar with that make, but it was not used on the back. And the last one in this group is a BSA motorcycle, four-speed vertical twin. That's an advertising real photo postcard. And again, not postmarked. So wow, what a nice group of postcards here, especially like the motorcycle ones and the truck ones. Make sure you come back for another installment. I do have a new box coming in shortly from the same person I'm purchasing from. So it'll be another couple thousand cards coming in shortly. And if you like this video, please make sure you like and subscribe. I really appreciate that. I love seeing comments from everybody. Please make sure you leave comments or ask questions. I'm always here to help anybody. You can also email me at postcardguy@aol.com. If you like this video, please make sure you like and subscribe and hit that little bell icon so you're notified when my latest video comes up. Once again, this is Kevin, and I hope you enjoy your day. Thanks, everybody.